There is a way to see if your brand or website is being mentioned by ChatGPT or Gemini. I'm going to show you a simple three-step process to find out. First, we'll get your information into the tool. Then we'll dive into the report. And finally, I'll give you a strategy to turn this insight into a massive competitive edge. Now, this will give you an advantage, but there's also a downside to it. To get our insights, to use this tool and support me at the same time, go to wpressdoctor.com/samrushai. This link is also in the description of this video and in the comments. And then we are at the website of Semrush, the most powerful SEO tools in history of mankind, in my opinion. Now, if you want to use the AI presence optimization tool, press over here on start now. Create an account with Semrush, and once you have done that, we can buy the AI SEO toolkit for $99 a month. Now, if you're not sure if this tool is right for you and your business right now, just watch this tutorial and I'll show you every single thing there is inside of this tool so you can decide if it's worth your money. But trust me, there's a lot of golden nuggets in there, and it gives you a lot of explanation and a lot of information about your current SEO AI status. So we click on over here on buy now, fill in your credit card information and click on subscribe. In this video, I will cover these three set of tools: AI analysis, brand performance and boost and monitor. We'll start with the first one, which is the visibility overview. By the way, if you want to see a complete Semrush A to Z tutorial talking about all these SEO tools, check out my other extensive tutorial over here, and that covers everything on Semrush SEO. Fill in your exact domain name over here. I'm going to use maseratifpuentohills.com. They're not sponsoring this video. I'm not affiliated with Maserati whatsoever. I've even never been to Maserati Puerto Hills, but I've used it in my extensive Semrush tutorial, so I thought it would be fun to also use it for this one. Immediately, we can see this dial that shows us our visibility is low. Now, that's of course not good. If you hover over it, you can see the industry average. This entire table over here shows us your brand's presence in AI-generated answers, measured by how often it's mentioned compared to the median number of mentions of competitors. On the right, we can see it changing over time per month. So if you keep coming back, you can see how your AI recommendations change over time. On the top over here, we can change the languages. More languages are coming soon. And here we can change the AI platforms. I would keep it on all AI platform for now. Then we scroll over here to topic and sources. There we have it. We have five different tabs. Your performing topics, see the topics where our brand is already mentioned. The topic opportunities, topics where our competitors are mentioned, but we are not. Then we have cited sources, domain referenced by LLMs in generated answers. Then we have source opportunities, very interesting. This sources where our competitors are mentioned, but we are not. And then you have your owned sources. These are your domain pages cited in answers by AI. For all tables, you can click on this arrow and see the actual prompt that Semrush has used. If you click over here on view full response, you can see how Semrush has determined the value on this and where your competitors or yourself are mentioned. And you can also from here monitor prompts, which is really great. Click over here on monitor. Then you get all the prompts per lines, all these specific prompts that are used inside of this category. And then we press on start tracking. There we are. Now, we will cover this later on over here at prompt tracking. Then we go to the next one, competitor research. Now, Semrush have already gathered your competitors over here. If they are not right, you can delete one over there and just add in more of them right here. Now on the right, you can see interesting competitor insights, which quickly gives you some strategic overview. Look at this. Now this is strategic information we can immediately apply to our online marketing strategy. But over here, you can find the real golden nuggets. Here are your competitors' mentions, but you are not. This way you can expand it. You can, of course, monitor it, create content for it. But if you go over here to sources, this is where LLMs find the information from your competitors on these websites, but not from your own website. Now, this is really pure gold. You can open it, view all the prompts, and you can monitor these prompts, contact the website owner, and try to add in your own content with your brand mention. Then we go over here to prompt research. Here we can approach it the other way around, add in the prompt that you want to be found on. Let's type in a regional prompt, something like, the tool is right now limited to only the prompts that being found inside of the AIs. So these prompts are used the most and captured by SEMrush. So if we go with the Bugatti dealers in California and Los Angeles, you can see some interesting metrics over there. It's the same, but the research is now from the prompt instead of your competitors. How can you use this tool? If you have one of these prompts over there, you can click on View Full Response. Here we can see the brands that are mentioned, and we can see the sources that AI is using to get all this information. Now, we can try to influence all these websites and make sure that our website, our URL, is also on one of these websites. Because if your website is being mentioned in all these sources, it's just a matter of time before the LLMs pick it up. And if we scroll all the way down, we are going to the related topics. In here, we can explore different kinds of topics related to our website and also the intent on the entire topic. And then we can click on Analyze Topic. And then again, we can dive deep in all the prompts that are being sent out to AIs. And we can see exactly if our brand is being mentioned on one of these and what to do, what sources to influence to get in these answers. All right, then we go over here to brand performance. Then the first thing we can see is the brand performance for our website. Now, this looks very good. Immediately, we can see insights. And that's what we want from SEMrush, just actionable strategy based on the latest data. We can see we have to publish factory trained credentials, toolset, all these things. You can click on it and then you can go over here to perception, narrative drivers and questions. So we'll be covering that in just a second. On the right side, we can see the share of voice versus sentiment. This basically means how often you're being mentioned on the horizontal axis, and on the vertical axis, you can see how positive there's being talked about your brand inside of the AIs. Very interesting. Then we scroll down, we can see the overall sentiment and the share of voice of all these. Well, we are just a small player in this world, but that's logical because we should aim more at the local competitors than the big brands worldwide. If you scroll down, you can see the key business driver by frequency. Business drivers are cross-brand factors that influence growth, such as value, trust, and access. These drivers are identified from recurring patterns in AI-generated answers about your brand and competitors. We can use them to benchmark performance and decide where to focus our efforts. So we can see all these business drivers over here, and we can see the big winners, which are going home with the most answers, these guys. And you can see the total mentions and the mentions of your brand. Very interesting information. If we then scroll down, we can see our brand versus our competitors, our share of voice, business driver by frequency. You can learn more everything about how it works. You can read it all over there. But this is to give you a big, good overview of how this all works. And you can compare all your competitors in here. Now, then we are at the AI strategic opportunities. Now, this is where the real fun begins. Because this is where you can see immediately short time frame actions, urgent time frame, and medium time frame. All these recommendations are really gold for your business. The only thing I'm missing over here is that we can actually place these recommendations in some list or something that we can use to send it to our colleagues. Because now I just have to go over here and copy these recommendations, put it inside of a document or something. But these recommendations are pure gold. And that's also the downside that I wanted to show you. It gives you a lot of work. It's good actually, but it's a lot. All right, let's move to the next one, which is the perception. In AI SEO, perception is mostly a technical and holistic assessment, not just a measure of positive or negative sentiment. It's measured by analyzing content quality, technical health, authority, user experience, and sometimes sentiment. Perception in AI SEO is a process by which AI models analyze our website, content, structure, and signals to understand its relevance, quality, and intent. And this will mirror how search engines like Google access our pages. It basically involves evaluating on-page elements, titles, headings, keywords, user experience, factors like readability, layout, and off-page signals like backlinks and authority. AI-powered SEO tools use perception to simulate search engines' algorithms, providing actionable feedback on how our website is likely to be perceived in search rankings. If we then scroll down, we are at the key sentiment drivers, which are very important and interesting to read. We have the brand strength factors perceived by LLMs over there and the areas for improvement. Well, if these are not correct, then we can scroll down and we can see the AI strategic opportunities, which talk exactly about fixed information gaps that AI already calls out. So this is exactly what you need to do. Again, I would like to have a button over here to put this on my short list to do right now, to do later on, to put it on the long run. This is very interesting stuff. These strategic opportunities. I love this from Semrush. It's pure gold. Then we go over here to narrative drivers. On the narrative drivers page, it helps us quickly understand what's working in our industry, so we can create content that match what people want and improve our chances of ranking higher in the AI search results. Immediately, we can see the insights and the share of voice by platform. Very interesting to check this out. Here we can see non-branded questions going in the future. If you come back later on, you can see week by week how things change. Also with the top domains, which are the top domains being used by AI, we can dive deeper to answers, not branded, branded citations, and we can see everything we want. And we can also see a detailed breakdown of the exact question and the answer the AI gave Semrush, which was put in this report. This way we can do some research and see exactly where we are being mentioned and not being mentioned. And again, if we scroll down all the way here, we go to the AI strategic opportunities. Again, I'm just repeating myself, but these recommendations are pure gold. Then we go over here to the questions. It gives you an insight on how the market is using AI, what type of topics they are pushing into AI and asking them about all these things. But this basically also shows us just the time we're living in and how we are using AI now. We're asking questions for education and comparison, and the rest is just a little bit less. For example, purchase and research is in our niche not happening that much. Here we can see the top topic analysis and patterns. This is really great to walk through it, to read it, to understand how people are using AI right now in your specific niche. Again, we are finishing with the AI strategic opportunities, which we can use to influence the AI answers. Then we go over here to the boost and monitor the growth actions is coming soon. We can go to site audit. And this is basically a technical audit of your website, which shows you exactly if you have any issues or problems with your pages on your current website. Why? Just like search engines, AI doesn't like to use your website as a source if your website is just slow, broken, or just plainly bad. Then we go over here to the prompt tracking. Here we can see the changes of the prompts that we were tracking via the other tools in the AI toolkit. We just click on our project. Over here you can see all targets, so that is like SEO. And if you go to AI search, you can see your project over there with all the prompts that you have been tracking. And we can see the different improved prompts, decline prompts, or all prompts. If you want to create a project, just remember you have to upgrade if you want to have more than one project over here. And the last one in this menu is the content creation. It's just a content creation tool from Semrush for $60 a month extra. Thank you for watching this short overview of this AI SEO tool from Semrush. If you have any questions, just drop them down in the comments. I'll always reply. Have a great day and hope you to see in this video over there, which shows you everything about the SEO tool from Semrush from A to Z. I'm going to walk you through everything in the toolkit. Have a great day and hope to see you in the next video.